Here we go, 20 lap super stock feature. Side by side on that first lap, Brad Davison come around. Let's lead the lap. Second lap, Brad Davison, your leader. Gary Blanket in second. Cody Thompson hold on to third. Michael Woods in fourth. Then it's Robbie Buchanan. And way on back to C4O, Logan Cobb. Coming by to the complete lap number 8, Brad Davison, your leader. Right there lurking on his back bumper, the 5 of Gary Blanket. Way on back, Cody Thompson holding on to third. As they ease over in turn number 4, Gary Blanket using that outside line, trying to catch up to the back bumper of Brad Davison. Now, Blanket will go to the bottom group, trying to get an advantage, see if he can find any way to catch up to the 88 of Brad Davison. Ten laps down, halfway through. Brad Davison now extends that lead just a bit over Gary Blanket, who got out of shape over in turn number 2. Gary Blanket not giving up. They come by to complete lap number 13. About a 2-car length advantage at Brad Davis as over Gary Blanket. Blanket closes in going down the back stretch. Gets right up, almost kisses the back bumper of Brad Davis as they come by to complete lap number 14. Gary Blanket all over the back bumper. Brad Davis slips a little bit once again over to turn number 2. Allows Davis to extend that lead. Fifteen down, 5 more to go. Brad Davis has led the way so far. Gary Blanket not giving up. We've got a caution with 4 laps to go. The 83 of Cody Thompson spinning on his own over in turn number 2. And that'll reset the field. And it'll be a four-lap shootout. Brad Davis trying to pick up his third win of the season. Two laps to go. Brad Davis, your leader. Gary Blinken not giving up. They'll come out and take the white flag. One more lap to go. Brad Davis, your leader. Gary Blinken right there in second. Here it comes out, folks. It's here for you, winner of the Super Stock Feature, Brad Davis. Third win of the season. And Brad, you turned in fast time, picked up your third win, but you said you was only running around six cylinders.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. It had all kinds of power, and I was like, oh, God, not again. And then I don't know what happened to it, but, man, that's all I had. I was just flat-footing it because we lost so much power. I don't know what's wrong with it.
And you just had to work at wheel because you knew that Gary Blinken was right on your back bumper by halfway through that race. Most of the race, he was catching up to you, but when he went down the back straightaway, you pulled away from him. But not bad for six cylinders.
No, well, we'll get over and jerk the hood off of it and see what's wrong with it. I'll give a shout-out to Gary Miller up there. If he's from our church, Locust, he's come over to watch it. I think it's the first time he's come here, and he's having a good old time.
And he's expecting to see you tomorrow morning, right?
Oh, yeah, I got to be there.
All right, folks. Once again, it's here for your winner. Third win of the season for Brad Davis. All right, here we go. Lights are out. Overholt Miracle on the front row. Clark and Ogle in the second row. 20-lap Sportsman Feature. Here we go. Caution was waving for the 54 of Mitchell Burke. And Wade Howerton coming down the front stretch, full blast. Slams the side of Burke. All right, here we go. Looking for the green this time by Jonathan Miracle, your leader. Clyde Overholt in second, Andy Ogle third. Now, Clyde Overholt, he goes to the inside of his teammate. They go side by side from up. What about Andy Ogle? He tried to make it three wide over and two. Still on ball now. That start waved off. And that restart waved off as we've got a drive shaft over in turn number two. Back to green, here we go. Clyde Overholt once again going to the inside of his teammate, Jonathan Miracle, looking for that lead. Andy Ogle lurking there in the third spot. Andy Ogle trying to use that low groove to get to the inside of Clyde Overholt. He'll reset, and now he'll dive to the inside, coming out of turn number four. They're side by side. Andy Ogle with advantage. Can he hold on, get out of turn number one? He'll slide up in front of Clyde Overholt to take over a second. Now Andy Ogle, he'll set his sights on the race leader, Jonathan Ogle. They'll go side by side down the back stretch. Coming even out of turn number four. Miracle will hold on the lead. Now they go into turn number one, and Andy Ogle tries to slide. They're making contact, still making contact as they come out of turn number two. Andy Ogle not giving up. Door to door, he'll have to slide right back behind Jonathan Miracle, who shuts the door. Andy Ogle not giving up as Clyde Overholt has now slid on back, and he has gone pit side. Your fast qualifier go pit side now once again. Andy Ogle, Jonathan Miracle drag racing down the back stretch. Ogle gets a little out of shape, and he'll have to let Miracle slide into the lead once again. So Andy Ogle looks like he may have the faster car, just cannot get out in front of your race leader, Jonathan Miracle. And so Dustin Hoover brings out his second caution. He tags the wall over in turn number one. Heavy front end. Going back to green. Here we go. 11 down. 9 more to go. Once again, Andy Ogle shoots to the inside of Jonathan Miracle. Looks like he might have a little bit. No, he had to slide up. And now David Clark, he's going to move up to the back bumper. Andy Ogle, see if he's got anything for that second place car. What a battle going on for the lead. Andy Ogle looking for any way he can get an advantage and trying to get Jonathan Miracle loose to see if he can get in front of him for the lead. 13 down, 7 more to go. And we've got a caution on the back stretch. The 7 of Matthew Smith, and only his second ever start here at Tazewell Speedway. 13 down, 7 more to go. Can Jonathan Miracle hold on for his 5th win of the season? Can Andy Ogle get around him for his first ever win? Andy Ogle once again putting pressure on Jonathan Miracle. He'd love to get up there and try to get him sideways to get around him. Jonathan Miracle, one of the best wheelmen ever here at Tazewell Speedway, former Pure Street champion. Down 5 more to go. Andy Ogle being pesky in that second spot. He wants his first Tazewell Speedway win. 16 down. Now he gets the best, tries to slide up, and he slides in front of the leader, Jonathan Miracle. Andy Ogle, your leader. Now we'll see if Jonathan Miracle can use that outside line. No, he slips up over in turn number two. David Clark will take over the second spot. 2 more laps to go. Jonathan Miracle goes from first to third. Andy Ogle, now he puts that 68 car into cruise control. White flag in the air for Andy Ogle. Chad Ogle, all smiles. Here he comes out. Let's hear it for your winner. His first ever Tazewell Speedway win, Chad Ogle. Let's let her say what she said. What'd you say, young lady?
It's a good night to be an Ogle.
It's a good night to be Ogle. Chad Ogle, you came up here a few weeks ago and ran with us. Tonight, persistence paid off. Your first ever Tazewell Speedway victory. What a job out there, man.
Hey, I appreciate it. I don't know what to say about all that. It's a good racetrack, and I'm glad we finally got it done there at the end.
And what we like, good, clean racing out there. You guys made a little contact. But, man, that's what guys like you live for, is to race side-by-side like that. And tell us about you finally got around Jonathan Miracle with about three to go.
Yeah, Jonathan's good up here. He always is. I thought we had a pretty good race car coming out. What can I say? I'm glad we finally got it done.
Hey, let's go over and let you celebrate. Let's have for your winner, first ever Tazewell Speedway victory for Chad Ogle.
Hey, Chad.